From Cornerstone Faith Assembly Church.
Tunawajia moja kwa moja kutoka kanisa la Cornerstone Faith Assembly.
We believe that the grace and the love of God is upon you.
Tunaamini neema na upendo wa Mungu uko juu yako.
Today, thank you for joining us even as we worship God.
Asante kwa kuunganika nasi tunapomsifu Mungu.
Let's have a short prayer even as I welcome the band.
Wacha tuombe alafu tuweze kukaribisha kikundi cha bendi.
Heavenly Father, we bless your name.
Tunabariki jina lako.
We thank you today
tunakushukuru siku ya leo
for the gift of life.
Kwa sababu umetupatia uhai.
And the opportunity to be in your house of prayer for all nations.
Na sifa ya kuwa katika nyumba yako wewe mfalme.
We thank you for everyone who is inside the church.
Tunakushukuru kwa wote ambao wako hapa kanisani.
Thank you also dear God.
Asante pia Mungu mpendwa.
For those who are joining us online.
Kwa wale ambao wanaungana nasi katika mtandao.
Both live and even to watch later.
Wale wanaotutazama moja kwa moja na wale watatutazama baadaye.
We thank you because we know as we minister to you.
Tunakushukuru kwa maana tunajua tunapohudumu.
Your spirit is also ministering us. And therefore, Lord, just have your way. As we praise you, as we bless you, as we adore your holy name, we declare that we have no other God but you. Other gods have ruled over us. Other gods have ruled over us.
Miungu mingine zimekuwa zikikuja kinyume chetu.
But it is your name, my Father.
Lakini ni jina lako wewe Mungu.
That we hallow.
Ambapo tunaabudu.
That we exalt.
Ambapo tunainua.
That we glorify.
Ambapo tunasifu.
And we lift up.
Na ambapo tunainua.
As we say.
Tunaposema.
That Jehovah you are God.
Na kwamba Mungu wewe Mungu.
In this place.
Mahala hapa.
In our nation.
Katika nchi yetu.
In the entire world.
Katika popote.
Blessed be your name.
Jina lako lisifiwe.
Both now and forevermore.
Sasa na hata milele.
Ekasala don. You are
Baba unastahili, wastahili sifa za mioyo yetu. Unastahili,
Lord, we worship.
Yes, Lord, Father, we exalt you. This afternoon we are saying that there is no other God like you, Jehovah. You are worthy to be magnified, worthy to be exalted this afternoon, O God. Be exalted, Abba Father, be magnified. Wastahili sifa za moyo wangu na kuabudu uliniumba ni kuabudu na kuabudu hemu na kuabudu Yesu wastahili sifa za moyo wangu nina kuabudu uliniumba ni kuabudu na kuabudu he Mungu wangu na kuabudu Yesu wastahili
wastahili
sifa za moyo wangu na kuabudu Yesu, 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 Yesu
stahili.
Wewe ni Bwana wa mabwana.
Sifa za moyo wangu.
Wewe ni Mungu mkuu Jehova Shabbat. Yesu tunakupea
sifa.
Ninakuabudu
na kuabudu.
Wewe ni Mungu wangu.
Mungu wangu.
Nakuabudu. Yesu wangu, Yesu wastahili, Baba unastahili,
sifa za moyo,
sipokee Jehova, tukuabudu mfalme na kuabudu. Kuabudu mfalme,
kuabudu.
Wewe ni Mungu peke. Yesu unastahili. Yesu unastahili.
Sifa za moyo.
Sifa za moyo wangu zipokee.
Kuabudu.
Pokea mabudu.
Umbali kuabudu.
Wewe ni Mungu unaweza mambo yote Bwana. Sifa za moyo wangu zipokee. Baba ninakuabudu.
Mungu wangu.
Ninakuabudu siku ya leo.
Nakuabudu.
Baba pokea mabudu.
Yesu.
Baba pokea sifa. Pokea sifa. Wewe ni Mungu mkuu. Wewe ni mfalme wa wafalme. Hakuna wa kufananishwa na wewe Jehova. Wewe ni Mungu mkuu. Hakuna kama wewe Yesu. Tunainua mikono yetu tukisema hakuna kama wewe Baba. Wewe ni Baba wetu. Wewe ni Baba yetu. Unastahili sifa. Pokea Jehova. Pokea zote. Hakuna kama wewe Baba. Wewe Yesu pokea sifa mchana wa leo. Hakuna wa kulinganishwa na wewe. Jina lako ni ngome imara. Ninapotajwa Jehova, magoti yote yanapigwa mbele zako, yakikiria kwamba wewe ni Mungu mkuu. Wewe unaweza. Wewe. Wewe. Falme wa wafalme. Zaidi ya yote hakuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe. Nakuabudu, ee Mungu wangu, nakuabudu, Yesu, ninakuabudu,
nakuabudu,
ee
Mungu wangu,
Yesu, ninakuabudu,
nakuabudu.
Baba ninakuabudu wewe peke yako.
Mungu wangu.
Ninakuabudu
mfalme.
Hey Yesu.
Yesu
ninakuabudu. Of my melody, you are all that matters. You are all that matters. I'll make room for two, you and I, Jesus. You are all that matters. You are all that matters. I'll put you in. In my life,
you are all that matters.
I'll make room for two.
I make you for two.
You and I,
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus,
you are all that matters.
You are all that matters.
You are all that matters.
I'll put you.
I'll put you in.
Jesus, I'll put you in front of my melody. You are all that matters in my life, oh God.
You are all that matters.
You are all that matters.
You are all that matters.
I beg you for two.
I beg you for two.
You and I,
Jesus.
Jesus, you are all that matters in my life. You are all that matters in my ministry.
You are all that matters.
I'll put you. Take the Holy Ghost. What would I be saying of me if I don't see your love? What would I be saying if you take away the Holy Ghost? Now I've come to realize that you. Father, you are all that matters. You are all that matters, oh God, to be where I am today. You are all that matters, oh God, Jehovah, to stand before you. You are all that matters, to stand here today. You are all that matters, oh God. Thank you, Jesus. You have enabled me, oh God. You are all that matters, oh God. You are all that matters in this service. You are all that matters, oh God. Jesus, you are all that matters. I put you.
are all that matters in our life. You are all that matters in this place. You are all that matters in this service.
Able to do ama kweli Mungu wetu anaweza kutenda over and above what we can think zaidi ya kile ambacho tunaweza kuwaza ask or even imagine ama kufikiria. Thank you so much the band. Asanteni sana we are well reminded of our God tunakumbushwa vyema habari ya Mungu wetu and what he can do na kile ambacho anaweza kufanya. Greetings to you once more salamu kwenu mara tena from wherever you are connected to us from
kutoka mahali popote ambapo unaunganika nasi.
This is Cornerstone Faith Assembly Church.
Hapa ni Cornerstone Faith Assembly.
On the behalf of our pastor Bishop Dr. Francis M. Kamau.
Kwa niaba ya mchungaji wetu daktari Bishop Francis Kamau.
And our resident pastor here Pastor Amos Mwangi.
Na mchungaji wetu wa makao haya Pastor Amos Mwangi.
And the entire leadership and membership of Cornerstone Faith Assembly.
Na uongozi wote wa Cornerstone Faith Assembly.
Feel welcome, you are in the right place at the right time. Jisikie
umekaribishwa uko mahali pasawa wakati uliofaa.
Amen. My name is Ben Okoth.
Jina ni Ben Okoth.
And I'm glad and grateful to God.
Na nashukuru kwa Mungu
for this opportunity to be used as a vessel to bring the word.
Kwa nafasi hii kutumika kama chombo.
Our title today
kichwa chetu leo
is Fear Not, God is with you.
Usiogope kwa sababu Mungu yuko pamoja nawe.
Amen.
Amina.
What a wonderful topic.
Ni kichwa cha ajabu namna gani?
To know that we ought not to fear.
Kujua kwamba hatustahili kuogopa.
Because God is with us.
Hatufai kuogopa kwa sababu Mungu yuko pamoja nasi.
Our reading is coming from the book of Isaiah chapter 41.
Somo letu ni kitabu cha Isaiah 41.
From verse 8 to 16.
Mstari wa 8 hadi 16.
I'll be reading from the NIV.
Nitasoma tafsiri ya NIV.
Then we will proceed from there.
Kisha tutaendelea kutoka pale.
In Jesus name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
From verse 8 to 16 I read.
Nasoma.
But you Israel are my servant, Jacob whom I have chosen, the descendants of Abraham my friend, you whom I have taken from the ends of the earth and called from its farthest regions, and say to you, you are my servant. I have chosen you and have not cast you away. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Verse 11. Behold, all those who were incensed against you shall be ashamed and disgraced. They shall be as nothing. And those who strive with you shall perish. Verse 12. Though you search for your enemies, you will not find them. Those who wage war against you will be as nothing at all. For I am the Lord your God, who takes hold of your right hand and says to you, do not fear. Somebody say, I will not fear.
I will not fear.
For God will help me. Do not be afraid. You warm Jacob, little Israel, do not fear. For I myself will help you, declares the Lord. Your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. See, I will make you into a threshing sledge, new and sharp, with many teeth. You will thresh the mountains and crush them, and reduce the hills to chaff. You will winnow them, the wind will pick them up, and a gale will blow them away. But you will rejoice in the Lord and glory in the Lord, in the Holy One of Israel. Amen.
Amen.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much because of the word that you have sent to us today. How we pray, Jehovah, that your word may encourage somebody today. May it bring hope where there is hopelessness, Father. May it cast out fear out of the lives of your people. Because from your mouth to our ears, O God, you are telling us, dear Jehovah, that we ought not to fear, for you are with us. This is the word you are telling somebody today. Fear not, God is with you. We bless your name in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amina.
Hallelujah. You may have your seats. Sometimes in life, life can mistreat you so badly until you wonder, does God really exist?
Je, Mungu yupo?
I don't know whether you have ever been to church or in the midst of the believers in a fellowship somewhere,
ama miongoni mwa waamini katika ushirika mahali,
and people are giving great testimonies,
na watu wanatoa shuhuda za ajabu,
and you are looking at your life, how things have fallen apart. Nothing seems to be working. You have prayed, you have waited. You have cried, you have fasted. You have given a seed. And sometimes even a sacrificial seed for that matter. You have perused the word of God. You have perused the word of God. And you have even repented of every known sin, including the sins of your ancestors, both true sins and imaginary ones. But sometimes you still look at your life and you are wondering, why are things not working? Why is life against you? Today I have come with a word from the Lord for you. Fear not. God is with you. In the world today, there are many people who are living in fear. Some of them are living in fear because of the bad economic times that we are in. I don't know which part of the world you are listening to this message from. But one thing in our nation of Kenya today is that the economy has turned against many people. The prices of basic commodities have skyrocketed. Many people do not know where they are going to get their next meal. Some parents and guardians, they are not even sure where they are going to get the school fees to pay for their children. The bills are so high. But perhaps your income cannot match. And for that reason, perhaps your heart is full of fear. Others are fearful today because they might have had a bad report from the doctor concerning their health or the health of their loved ones. There are many, many reasons which can cause many people to fear. Those who have read the Bible well,
waliosoma Biblia vizuri,
they say
wanasema,
that over 365 times
mara kama 365
the Bible says
Biblia inasema,
do not fear,
usiogope.
That tells us
yo inatuambia,
that every morning
kwamba kila asubuhi,
there is a chance that somebody would wake up in fear.
Kuna uwezekano kwamba mtu ataamka akiogopa.
But God's word says,
lakini neno la Mungu lasema,
do not fear,
usiogope.
There is a fear not in the word of God for you every single day that you wake up.
Kuna neno usiogope kila siku ya maisha yako ya mwaka.
Our God understands.
Mungu wetu anaelewa.
He knows where the kind of earth we are living on.
Anajua mahali ambapo tunaishi duniani hii.
Many things are pressing the people of God.
Mambo mengi yanasonga watu wa Mungu.
From every direction.
Kutoka kila pembe.
Within the family.
Ndani ya familia.
From the government.
Kutoka na serikali.
A lot of things.
Mambo mengi.
Are coming against many people.
Yanakuja kinyume cha watu
wengi. And many are living in fear today.
Na wengi wanaishi kwa kuogopa
leo. But the word of God is coming to you today.
Bali neno la Mungu la kujia leo.
And that word is saying,
na hilo neno la sema,
fear not,
usiogope.
For God is with you.
Maana Mungu yupo pamoja na
wewe. These are the words that God spoke to Jacob.
Haya ndio maneno Mungu alinena na Yakobo.
And he told Jacob,
akamwambia Yakobo,
you are my servant.
Wewe ni mtumishi wangu.
Fear not,
usiogope.
For I am with you.
Maana niko pamoja na wewe.
You know there's nothing as good in this planet earth.
Unajua hakuna kitu kizuri kama dunia hii.
As to know,
kama kujua,
that one who created the earth,
ya kwamba aliyeumba dunia hii,
the one who is the superpower,
yule ambaye nguvu zote ni zake,
the one with whom there is no impossibility,
na ambaye kwake hakuna lisilowezekana,
the God that we are preaching to you about,
Mungu ambaye tunamhubiri kwako leo,
is with you,
ako pamoja na
wewe. It is possible to be in God.
Unaweza kuwa pamoja na Mungu.
And certain things are not working as you expect.
Mambo mengine haendi kulingana na matarajio yako.
But refuse to fear,
lakini akataa kuogopa.
Because God,
maana Mungu,
is with you.
Ako pamoja nawe.
If the mightiest and the strongest is with you,
yeye ndiye Mungu mwenye nguvu zote na ako pamoja nawe.
Why should you fear?
Na basi kama yako nawe uogope kwa nini?
You know, God, whenever the Bible tells you not to fear,
unajua Biblia inapokuambia usiogope,
then there must be a reason.
Kuna sababu.
God spoke to Joshua.
Mungu alinena na Joshua.
And he told Joshua.
Na akamwambia Joshua,
be encouraged.
Uweze kuhimika.
Do not fear.
Usiogope.
If you hear God telling you not to fear,
Mungu anaposema usiogope,
he knows.
Anajua.
He understands.
Anaelewa.
That there are issues that will come your way.
Kwamba kuna mambo yatakayokuja maishani mwako.
Or circumstances that are already surrounding your life.
Ama hali ambayo inazingira maisha yako.
Which are already making you to fear.
Inayokufanya uogope.
But he tells you,
lakini anakuambia,
even in the midst of all that,
hata miongoni mwa mambo hayo yote,
do not fear.
Usiogope.
For I the Lord,
maana mimi Bwana,
I am with you.
Ni pamoja nawe.
I am greater.
Mimi ni mkuu.
I am mightier.
Mimi ni mwenye nguvu.
Than any power.
Kuliko nguvu zozote.
Than any force in the world.
Na zozote duniani.
That can cause you to fear.
Zinazoweza kuleta uoga ndani
yako. God is greater.
Mungu ni mkuu.
He is more powerful.
Yeye ana nguvu.
Than that reason in your place of work.
Kuliko hiyo jambo kazini mwako.
That is causing you sleepless nights.
Inayokusababisha usilale
usingizi. God is greater.
Mungu ni mkuu.
He is more powerful.
Ana nguvu.
Than that bad report.
Kuliko hiyo report
ambayo umepata. That you have received.
Ambao umepata.
Concerning your life or that of your family member.
Maisha yako ama mmoja wa jamii yenu.
So do not fear.
Usiogope basi.
Number one lesson we learn from the text we have read today.
Jambo la kwanza, mafunzo la kwanza ambao tunajifunza kutoka ile ambacho tumesoma leo.
Of Isaiah chapter 48.
Kutoka kitabu kile ambacho tumesoma.
I want us to know.
Nataka tujue.
And that God knows you both by your official and your nickname.
Kwamba Mungu anakujua kwa majina yako rasmi na yale mengine ambao watu wanakuita.
Hemson, as you are seated there.
Hemson, ukiwa umekaa pale.
We may not know the nickname that people used to call you in the village or in the school.
Hatujui ulikuwa unaitwa nani kule vijijini zaidi ya jina lako.
But God knows you.
Lakini Mungu anakujua.
Even by that name.
Hata kwa hilo jina.
That same very is that very same God.
Na huyo huyo Mungu.
He knows even our bishop with his other nickname.
Anajua hata askofu wetu na majina yote yake.
Wherever you are.
Popote ulipo.
God knows the name that your mother or your father gave to you. you. And he also knows the name that you gave yourself. You know, sometimes people are not comfortable with the name that they were given. Therefore, they can change their name. There's nothing wrong with that. You know one thing, that even by that name you have given yourself, even if it is not in your official ID, God knows you by that name. And that is why he called Israel. He also referred to him as Jacob.
Na pia Yakobo.
When you read the Bible well, the name Jacob
jina Yakobo
means to follow,
maana yake ni kufuata,
or to be behind,
ama kuwa nyuma.
Remember, Jacob was a twin with Esau.
Kumbuka Yakobo alikuwa pacha wa Esau.
And he was the last twin, the second twin.
Na yeye ndiye alikuwa wa pili kutoka.
So he was behind Esau.
Kwa hivyo alikuwa nyuma ya Esau.
Somebody today,
mtu leo,
you may be looking at your life,
unaweza kujiangalia maisha yako,
and you are seeing that you are behind.
Na unaona kwamba uko nyuma.
Your peers have left you behind. The people you grew up together, they are advancing in life, but you look at your own life, you seem to have been left behind, and you are wondering, until when, God, will things change for me? Do not let fear to grip your heart, because other people are doing better than you are. And time is coming, and that time is soon, that God will step in the picture, and he will change your circumstances. Your story will change, and those who will left you behind, they will look at you and they will acknowledge that God has truly helped you. The other meaning of the name Jacob is a deceiver. You also know that he deceived his brother Esau. So he did not have a good past. Perhaps today you are looking at your past, the things you used to do, the way you are a drunkard, perhaps you are a prostitute, you might have messed up yourself in the past, just as the name Jacob was not a good meaning name at all. But even with all that, God is not looking at your past. He is not judging you based on what you have done in the past. He is telling you, do not think that things are not working for you, that the earth is against you because of your past life. He forgave you, and he forgot about it, and he has opened a new page for you so that you can move forward. Do not let your past to hold you back. Move forward. Behold, the old is gone and the new has come. So choose to move with God. Tell your past, you belong to my past. Now the life that I'm living, I'm living in the Lord Jesus Christ, who loved me and who gave his life for me. Therefore I will not fear. There are times you have to speak to yourself and tell yourself that even if things are not working for us in the family, even if we are going to bed hungry, we will not fear. It doesn't matter what is happening against us. Our God is for us. He is not against us. He will not deceive us. Neither will he forsake us. So fear not. God knows you by name. Another important thing that we need to know, that is our God, he also knows us by the addresses that we are coming from.
He
spoke to Jacob. And he told him that though you come from the farthest ends of the earth, I am the one who chose you. And I have loved you. Sometimes you look even at where you are staying in. The roads leading to that place, they do not even have an address. If somebody asks you, if I want to visit you, can you please drop for me a pin, the Uber pin? Your address is nowhere. Because you are living in the midst of nowhere. Even in that place, God still knows you. He does not know you because of your great name. He knows you because he loves you. He formed you in his image and in his likeness. And he's telling you, refuse to fear. Do not look at the external circumstances. Because he is with you. Number two, God has called you to serve him,
Mungu amekuita umhudumie,
and above that,
hayo,
to be his friend.
Uwe rafiki yake.
In verse 9, the Bible says, as I read, that you whom I have taken from the ends of the earth, and I have called you from its farthest regions, and I said to you, you are my servant. Wherever you are, God has called you to serve him. Sometimes we think that serving God is doing something in the church. It is okay. It is something. Some serving God does not mean that you have to be somebody holding the microphone and preaching like our bishop does, or like Benny
Hinn,
or standing like Sister Margaret here and leading people in worship. All that is good and it is serving God. But I want you to understand that whatever God has called you to do, even if you are in an NGO, you are visiting people who are hopeless in the society and giving them hope, you may not even be paid well, but even in that, know that you are serving God. You might be in the slum somewhere. You are reaching out to the widows and to the needy. Even that one is also called serving God. Even if you are a
mama mboga,
people come to you and they buy your sukuma wiki. God has placed you there to serve him. You can encourage a soul there. You can speak one word of God to somebody who is hopeless. Just where you are. You may be a sweeper in a certain factory. I remember when I came to
Nairobi,
one of the first jobs that I got was to sweep in a government institution, and things were so tough for me there because the income was peanuts, but my bill was so high. And at first, I did not really accept that job. But with time, God trained me. And he taught me that he had put me there for a purpose. I began praying for the people who were working there. And things began to change for the better in that institution. Wherever you are, God has called you to be his servant. Don't look down on yourself. And remember,
above
serving God, God expects you to rise higher and become his friend. That is what he was telling Jacob. That you,
Jacob,
the descendant of my friend Abraham.
Abraham
was the first person that God referred to as a friend. And you know what? It did not end there. In the Bible, in the New Testament, the Bible says, the Lord Jesus Christ said, for I no longer call you servants, but I call you friends. For a servant does not know what the master is doing. God is looking on you.
Mungu anakuangalia
wewe. And he expects you
na anatarajia
to rise above the servanthood mentality.
Uinuke juu ya ile hali ya kujisikia
mtumwa. And become his friend.
Na uwe rafiki yake.
Hemston, God is taking, is looking on you.
Hemston, Mungu anakuangalia.
He's expecting you.
Anakutarajia
to look at him.
Umuangalie
and consider him your friend.
Na uweze kumchukua kama rafiki yako.
The times to just be relate with God as a servant.
Kuna nyakati ambazo unamchukua Mungu kama unajikua kama mtumwa.
And it ends there as come to an end. Step further. And get into the higher bracket and become God's friend so that before God does something he will consider you as he considered Abraham when he wanted to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah. He said, shall we do something before we inform our friend Abraham? When you
have prayed
your relationship with God, then God will lift you to that level when you now become his friend. Nothing will be happening to you unless God first shows it to you. Level number three. Point number three, the Bible says, fear not, for God is with you. That we find in verse 10, where the Bible says, fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. You know, when things that causes fear come your way, one of the things that people lose is strength. People become feeble because of the things that are not working for them. But God is telling you today, it doesn't matter what comes your way. Refuse to fear. You know, you have a choice on how you react. There is a power that you may not be having. And that is the power to determine what happens to you. But one sure thing is that God has given you the power to choose how you react to what happens to you. You may not determine what other people do to you. You may not have that power. But as to how you react to what others say or do to you, that power is within you. So fear not. God is with you. One of the boldest people on earth is a son or a daughter who is holding the hands of their father. You know, when I was young, when my father would come from the town to the village and hold my hand as we walk in the village, I could boast because I knew that even the young boys who were showing muscles unto me, the few of them who were stronger than me and would beat me from time to time, when I was holding the hands of all, my father was holding my hands, I was the boldest. And every child knows that their father is the strongest in the world. If there is a kind of faith that children have, is to have that belief in them. The children believe
that their fathers are the strongest. As a child of God, believe that your heavenly Father, He is the strongest. He is the mightiest. He is stronger than that reason which is causing you to fear. So refuse to fear. In the name of Jesus. You know when a father is walking with their child, when they're walking on a plain ground, the father holds the hands of the child. But when it comes to where now the father needs to step to step kuruka something like a valley, then the father would always carry the child and help the child to cross safely. That is what God, your heavenly Father, will do for you. That in this journey of life, God will hold you with His righteous right hand, even when trouble comes your way, like a father holds the hand of her daughter. God will hold your hand. He will lift you and He will cause you to go over that trouble, and He will take you to the other side. Therefore fear not. It doesn't matter what valley is before you. This God is strong enough. He will hold you by His righteous right hand, and He will do just the necessary to make sure that He helps you to cross over to the other side, that He helps you to overcome that trouble, that He helps you to make sure that whatever has been causing you confusion in your place of work, that thing will be addressed in whatever way that you need the help of God. He will help you. Point number four. The enemies you see today, you will see them no more. And that we get in verse 11, where the Bible says, behold, all those who are incensed against you, they shall be ashamed and disgraced. In the NIV it says that all who rage against you will surely be ashamed and disgraced. Those who oppose you, they will be as nothing and they will perish. That is the statement that God told the children of Israel. That the enemies you see today, you will look for them and you will not find them. And that is the word that God is sending to you today. That whatever is rising against you will look for it, but you will not see it. The powers that are rising against you, you will look for them and you will not see them. Therefore, the enemies that you are seeing today, the problems that are in your life today, you will see them no more. They are only here for a moment. Those problems are only here for a moment. Just as the Bible says, that morning may last for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Whenever you see that things are so hard and tough in your life, know that your morning is about to come, and your morning will come to an end. Whenever you see things are not working, things are against your life, what it means is that you have a great destiny in God, and therefore God is telling you that the troubles, Nixon, that you are seeing today, those troubles, you will see them no more. God is speaking to somebody today. The challenges that have been in your life, you will look for them
and you will not see them. And therefore, fear not. God is on your case to make sure that He helps you. Therefore, fear not. Tell yourself that I refuse to fear, because the enemies I see today, I will see them no more. In the name of Jesus. Point number 5. In your weakness, God's power is made perfect. That is what the Apostle Paul said when God told him that my grace is sufficient for you. Then for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weaknesses, so that Christ's power may rest on me. That is why, for Christ's sake, I delight in weaknesses, in insults, and in hardships, also in persecutions and in difficulties. Things may be difficult for you. Remember, things were also difficult for Apostle Paul. He was called by God, but just because he was called by God did not mean that he was not going to be persecuted, did not mean that things were not going to be difficult for him. You are not the first and you are not the last. There are other people in the past who have gone through the same things you are going through, or perhaps worse than what you are going through. But God stayed true to them. Their weaknesses gave an opportunity for God's power to be made manifest and perfect. Another thing, point number 6 as we wind up, is that God wants to metamorphosize your life before He uses you. Some of you, your destiny in God is great, but the assignment that God has called you to do, you need some preparation. God needs to allow some storms to come into your life so that He can shake you up. He can make you. He can harden you. He can change your character through the things that He allows to come your way before He uses you. So do not fear. Some of the reasons you are going through tough circumstances is because God is changing your life before He can use you. The last point today, point number 7, is that God wants to use you to do great and mighty things beyond your imagination. From verse 15 and 16, the Bible says, as I read, that see, I will make you into a threshing sledge, new and sharp, with many teeth. You will thresh the mountain and crush them and reduce the hills to chaff. You will winnow them. The wind will pick them up. The assignment that God has called you to do, it is greater than you may think. And God needs to transform you before He puts you on that assignment. God was referring to Jacob as Awam. Awam is something that is helpless. When you compare it to a mountain, but God told Jacob that I will transform you, I will make you into a threshing sledge, that the mountains that are before you, you will crush them, you will winnow them, into powder. I don't know if you have ever seen a caterpillar. The ones that road constructors use. You know that thing, it's so powerful. That when it goes to a mountain and it begins to dig the mountain, it takes you less effort. The driver that is driving that tractor, he uses less effort, but it does great work. That is what God wants to do with you. After he transforms you, he wants to make you that you will use less effort and do great work within the shortest period of time. So fear not. He has been preparing you. Wherever he has called you and sent you to, do not fear. Do not hesitate. Just go. Because whatever he wants to accomplish, he is not depending on your own power, but he has, as he transforms you, he will use you to do great and mighty things. So I want you to tell yourself that I will not fear, for God is with me. He will help me. There are messages you need to personalize and tell yourself, if that is what God is saying, then I believe it. Therefore I will not fear. Say with me, I will not fear. God is with me. He will help me. I'm not moving in my own power, but I'm moving in the power of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name, as we sing this song, God is too faithful to fail you. Amen.
Amina.
You are too faithful to fail me. You are too faithful to disappoint me. You've proven yourself in my life, and I've come to realize you are too faithful to fail me.
Indeed, our God is too faithful to fail us.
He will
not fail you. He is too faithful to fail you. Tell yourself that, my God, you are too faithful to fail me. Therefore, I refuse to fear. In Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for everyone who is listening to this message. Whatever has come their way to cause them to fear, today, by the authority that has been given to us, we bind the spirit of fear. And we cast it out in the name of Jesus. For we do not give us the spirit of fear, but that of power, of love, and of a sound mind. You said it, we believe it, in Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you. There are people who trust you, dear Father, that because you are too faithful to fail them, they can partner with you, Jehovah, through giving, so that they can support your work. And dear Heavenly Father, we pray for anyone, dear God, man or woman, who might be touched today, dear God, in their hearts, to stand with your work here, O God, by sending their offerings, as using the numbers provided on the screen, or by writing a check and posting it, O God. Father, we pray, let your faithfulness be made manifest in their lives. Cause them, dear Father, to be bold enough to refuse to fear in this life, because you are too faithful to fail them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
You are too faithful to fail me.
You are
who you yesterday, today, and forevermore. What you say is what you do. You never fail, you never change. You are faithful to the end. Faithful God, I worship you. I worship you. Oh Jesus, you are too faithful to fail me. You are too faithful to disappoint me. You've proven yourself in my life, and I've come to realize you are too faithful to fail me.
And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ
and the love of God, fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the presence of our Father.